everybody, it's me, Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie. On this episode of CD Junkie, I'm going to talk about an incredibly gifted Irish singer-songwriter by the name of Thomas Walsh and his band Pugwash. Now, if you haven't heard Pugwash or Thomas Walsh, you are in for a complete treat. If you are a fan of the Beatles, 10cc, XTC, ELO, the Kinks, and even Brian Wilson, you are going to love Thomas Walsh and Pugwash. Incredible music that just stirs the heart, stirs the soul, and encourages you to tap your toes. It's just wonderful, great pop music. Now, sometimes when people talk about Jellyfish, they talk about the complex arrangements and the wonderful melodies. Well, that's what you get with Pugwash. It's not as, you know, gloriously produced as Jellyfish, but it just brings to the surface many of those same emotions, those joyful emotions that you get when you listen to great pop music. Now, on some of these episodes, I like to talk about how I got into the band, and it's very simple, because my buddy Jim played me the album from the Duckworth Lewis Method. Now, this band is very cricket-centric. Both the group's name and the lyrics of the album are inspired by the game of cricket, as you can see on the cover there. It's a really wonderful, lighthearted, fantastic album of pop songs. Now, the band consisted of Neil Hannon from the group The Divine Comedy, just a great songwriter on his own. In fact, he wrote the music for the new movie Wonka. And the other guy in the band was Thomas Walsh. And my buddy Jim says, yeah, he's from a band called Pugwash. So I had to dive into Pugwash. Now, this was in 2009. Before I dive into Pugwash, I'm going to let you know that the Duckworth Lewis Method also put out another album called Sticky Wickets. And that came out in 2013. But let's get into Pugwash. Formed in Ireland, they put out their first album, Almond Tea, in 1999. Great introduction to this wonderful songwriter. Very inventive, very eclectic, eccentric, but also very glorious pop. The debut album, Almond Tea, came out in 1999, and it was followed in the year 2002 by the album Almanac. Now, there was an Australian compilation that came out in about 2003, but I could never find any Pugwash albums until 2005 when the Jollity album came out. And this is incredible, with string arrangements from Dave Gregory from XTC, plus a song co-written with Andy Partridge from XTC. The album also has like Eric Matthews on it, a really super talented guy by the name of Tosh Flood. It's just really, really wonderful collection of songs. You know, when I talk about him being influenced by the Beatles, he's not like just a McCartney influenced guy or just a Lennon. You know, he's both. You know, he's got the wit and the bite of Lennon, but he's also got the sweet beauty of McCartney. And like I said, Jeff Lynne is in there, Andy Partridge, you know, influences, really wonderful. This was a wonderful introduction for me to get into the band because I was never able to find the Almond Tea or Almanac albums on CD. But some of the compilations that I'll show you here do have songs from those two albums. Now, the next album was called 11 Modern Antiquities, came out in 2008. Another great and wonderful album there. And he's joined in the band by Keith Farrell and Johnny Boyle, but also Neil Hannon appears on this album. Jason Faulkner's on this album. Dave Gregory, Eric Matthews again, Tosh Flood again. Plus Nelson Bragg, who was in Brian Wilson's band at the time. Really super talented American musician and songwriter. Michael Penn's on the album. And again, I believe that Andy Partridge co-wrote a couple songs there as well. Definitely just more delightful, fantastic, heartwarming pop music. Now, briefly, he was signed to Andy Partridge's label, and they put out a compilation called Giddy. And this is a, you know, funny little packaging here. You know, this lifts off and reveals that, and the album slides out. But this is a great compilation, features songs from all the albums that I just talked about. A great introduction to Pugwash if you find this compilation out there in the wild or online. Now, the next album came out in 2012, and that was called The Olympus Sound. Now, and this album had a more solid version of Pugwash. It was a quartet at this time. It was Thomas Walsh, Tosh Flood, Sean McGee, and Joe Fitzgerald, and another collection. You know, this seemed a little bit more raw than 11 Modern Antiquities, but still clever and glorious songs, just floating around the room, you know, as you play this music. It's just really, really wonderful. Lots of great songs on there. The album also features guest appearance from Ben Folds, Andy Partridge, Dave Gregory, Neil Hannon, the usual suspects, but very talented individuals helping out Pugwash. But Pugwash are really barreling through and creating music that is just mind-blowingly wonderful. Now, I don't know if anything had been released in the U.S. at that time, but Omnivore Records stepped in, and they released this wonderful compilation called A Rose in a Garden of Weeds, a preamble through the history of Pugwash. This came out in 2014, and this features tracks from the albums that I've talked about. A great collection. Great, great, great introduction. The following year, in 2015, out comes Play This Intimately as If Among Friends. And this not only features the four-man Pugwash, but also guest appearances from Ray Davis from the Kinks, Neil Hannon, Andy Partridge, and it's really just stunning. It's just another great collection of songs. You know, the thing about the Pugwash albums is it isn't all the same. You know, you're going to get something that's really jangly, maybe has a sort of a psych feel to it. And then right after that, a piano ballad. Then right after that, something, with a, you know, ukulele and timpani and piano. And, you know, that sounds like it, you know, could be played at a circus. And the next thing after that is going to be a glorious Beatles-esque song. And just Pugwash, always keeping it fresh, always keeping it real. But after this, Thomas Walsh dissolved that lineup of Pugwash, but he still continued under the name, and he recorded Silver Lake with Jason Faulkner from Jellyfish and the 3 o'clock. And this is another album, more low-key, maybe a little bit less produced, but still glorious. You know, when Thomas Walsh comes in with his double triple track vocals, it's just mana from heaven. Really great collection of songs there too. Now at that point, I believe that Pugwash ceased to exist, but there was another compilation that came out in Japan, and that was called Popularity Pending, 20 Years of Pugwash, the Greatest Hits Album. And another wonderful collection. Each of the compilations that I've talked about, you know, the one on Omnivore and then the one on Andy Partridge's label, they all have something different about them, either a different feel, you know, some similar songs, maybe a lot of similar songs, but there's always something special on each of them. This is no exception. A really wonderful collection, a must-have for any Pugwash collector. So then after that, Thomas Walsh went solo, and in 2023, on the wonderful Curation Records label, out came The Rest Is History. Sorry. Incredible. Wonderful. You know I was going to say it, because Thomas Walsh remains an amazing singer-songwriter. Now, I will admit that there are other Pugwash releases out there, things like demo collections or alternate mixes and stuff. Those are very, very hard to get, and I don't think I'm ever going to be able to afford to track that stuff down. So I just wanted to focus on the main studio albums and some of the great compilations that you can still get. But if you're still not sold on what an amazing artist that Thomas Walsh is, I have put together a medley for you. Now, this medley features snippets of one song off the first two albums and then two songs off of all the other studio albums that I talked about. Not necessarily the compilations, but some of these songs are on those compilations, if that makes sense. So I want you to hear this because it's glorious. It's wonderful pop. It's going to move you and it's going to motivate you. So sit back, relax, give this a listen, and I will see you on the other side. Hey!
Good. to be fun. It's nice to be nice.
Go round again. Dog chasing horses on a carousel.
Well, that's it. I hope this inspires you to check out the music of Thomas Walsh and Pugwash. Like I said, if you're here in the U.S., there were a few releases on the wonderful Omnivore Recordings label, and there's also the brand new Thomas Walsh album on the wonderful Curation Records label. And I just can't get enough. I'm not going to say anymore. All I'm going to say right now is thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. I really appreciate it. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, to ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me. I'm Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie.